for permits and inspections in the city. Just going to go over, and again, I'd like to start on page two where we look at fund balances. So, as you can see, the last couple of years, COVID-related, so you see that we took a large chunk out of our fund balance over the years. The estimated fund balance at the end of fiscal year 23 is approximately 197,000. And then fiscal year 24, that number remains the same, about 198,000, which is probably 8% of revenue. Going over some of the highlights, our current budget right now for revenue in the fund is 2.3 million. We're actually amending that to go down about 113,000. And that's registered related to the rental inspection being lower than what was anticipated. And then going into next year, fiscal 24, we anticipate the revenues to be at 2.4 million. On the expense side, fiscal 23, total expenses 2.2 million. And then fiscal 24, total expenses 2.4 million. And Jesse's here to answer any questions that you may have.
Looking at the personnel, there was a request for one additional FTE, and that was denied. Correct?
Correct.
Any questions from the council?
Yeah. Jesse, rental inspections. Where are we at?
Through the chair, we are finally getting things underway. A lot better than they were previously. We're still behind on them. We're way down on them. I want to say we have a total of 29 rental apartment complexes here in the city. We have, I want to say maybe a half a dozen. I couldn't tell you for a fact, but about a half a dozen of them are in full compliance. And that leaves the rest to be, you know, we're playing catch up right now.
My question is, we have the plumbing inspector, we have building inspectors, we have part-time heating and cooling, part-time electrical.
Yes.
So to have just a rental inspector, do they have to be any of those skilled trades? Could we hire somebody that you could train to certify them to go do these rentals and stuff?
Through the chair, yes. We can do that.
And by doing that, would they be able to cover their own cost?
Absolutely. You know, there's a lot of, it's not even just the apartment complexes that we have. We have, I'm sorry, I don't think the number's not on my brain. We have a lot of rental homes here in our city as well. So there is a lot of work out there to be done. We're constantly at it. As people buy and sell homes, we're doing inspections on them, and then plus the folks that have rentals in our city as well.
So one other point I'd like to make. If we have this rental inspection program that the state authorizes, and like that, and we don't get these done, and there's an issue at one, and somebody gets hurt, are we liable because we didn't do the inspection? Could you be liable?
Well, it starts off as a property owner, it's their responsibility to make sure. So we don't know every time there's a transaction that happens to where somebody else has bought, let's say a house, and they want to keep it as a rental. I hate to say it, I don't see the system somewhat. If you run it through the bank, it's almost all banks are going to say they want city certs to be done, at least done. Most of them, they want them completed. But if you pay cash for a house, it bypasses the, a lot of times it bypasses us.
I'm talking more about the apartment complexes, places like Harry's Glen that we had trouble getting into.
Yes.
You know, that we know has to be inspected every 3 years.
Yes, absolutely.
And if they're not getting inspected and there's an issue, I'm just wondering if we're liable.
Well, it's our ordinance. We never had rental inspections until the city council passed the ordinance. So I think the program's been going on maybe about 18 years, something like that, and sorry, Mr. Mayor.
Cut to the chase here. So this is definitely something we're in discussions with right now. The building department, we're kind of trying to figure out a game plan moving forward. We've talked about adding two rental inspectors, but we just don't know, it would probably come back as a budget amendment because we don't know when we can actually get this rolling. The biggest issue with the rental apartments was the scheduling. And that's what we just discovered over the last few months is that they weren't getting scheduled. So we had inspectors sitting in our, you know, when you can't do the cement, you know, during the frost thaw and all that other stuff, we had people sitting in the room with no inspections. And the people that do those inspections is the call center. That wasn't getting done. Once we realized that, we got on that, and now that is a top priority. However, now the, you know, it's getting warm out, they're going to be doing the garage and the cement and all that other stuff, but we're trying to figure out a game plan moving forward to add two possible rental inspectors, where that's all they do. And like you said, they do not have to be certified like a cement inspector or a plumbing inspector and stuff like that. Because we do think there's revenue there.
So wouldn't it be wise to have a clerk that's just assigned to the building department that does the scheduling?
Through the chair.
That the inspectors can call and they can get information from, you know?
Yes, eventually, 100%. But right now, we have a dedicated person in our call center that is scheduling on a daily or weekly basis. So one of those people over there will be calling apartments to make sure we're scheduling. And then just Mr. Harrington, when he's here, so I guess I can say his name. And I'm not sure what the title is, but they're to make sure they're looking at the schedules weeks out to make sure that the inspectors' schedules are full. So, but there's a game plan to kind of bring back the building department to the way it was. But we're just, and Jesse can even attest to this, we're just not nowhere near prepared to do that because there's more people than what we anticipated is needed in that department.
Council?
Through the chair, sorry, no one asked a question. It was pretty successful years ago.
Oh, absolutely.
The person's still there. Help run that, so maybe you should pick that person's brain, you know.
Sure, we talked to multiple people. We talked to Jesse, we talked to the call center person, or manager. We talked to a person in my department that used to work in that department, a person in your department that used to work in there. And basically the conversation, there needs to be roughly 4 to 5 people in there to run everything. We just don't have the trained staff to do that right now.
That's
why we're gonna kind of do it in pieces.
Right, excuse me, Mayor. It's not just one person that set these things up. It's multiple. It's quite a few of the clerks that we have in the call center is who's scheduling these inspections to be done. We're having problems with not only just having that take place, we want to schedule the inspections. We want to do the inspection. Some of these places don't want to come in for the inspections, or we just keep getting excuses. And don't get me wrong, so I'm really strong on sending out tickets now. If they're not wanting to come in and pay for it, I have no other choice. It's just that we don't want the city to start falling down. The community doesn't need to be falling down. We need to be picking up. And in other words, this is all based off the International Property Maintenance Code, our inspections, and we take that very seriously. Keeps our community clean here. Basically, if something's broke,